Happy Monday, everybody. Time for another Mailbag Monday. All right, let's start with this one. As usual, Canada Post has put their sticker over the thing, so it's hard to see what it is. We'll just have to go in with no forewarning. It is 4-5. Oh. Yeah, 5 of those, whatever those are. What do we got here? 5. So we've got a little antenna track printed on there, and a chip, a transistor driving that antenna track, and an assortment of resistors and capacitors. What is that? What is that when it's sitting right side up? It is. RCWL9196 to the Googles. So what is this guy? Oh, a radar motion detector. Okay. Microwave radar sensor switch. All right. Who's this guy? Roger Clark. That looks an awful lot like the same module that I got. He keeps saying radar in quotation marks. And he's calling them really cheap. I guess I should go and look up the listing for them. 5 pieces RCWL-0516 microwave radar sensor switch. Module body, induction module, 100 milliamps. Induction. Okay. I bought these as an auction item. 5 pieces for $2.87 Canadian. Free shipping from China, Hong Kong. What does it say about it down here? 4 to 28 volts. Typically just under 3 milliamps. Can detect bodies, I guess, between 5 and 9 meters. Transmits at around 20 milliwatts. Output voltage, 3.2 to 3.4 volts. Can drive an output current of 100 milliamps. So it could drive an LED directly or an optoisolator, and then you can do whatever you want. What else? Repeat trigger, output, the output signal low, binary low is 0 volts and high is 3.3. Operates between minus 20 and 80 Celsius, which is, okay, so I can't use it outside in the winter, I guess, but other than that, it's pretty reasonable. Oh, and there's some different ways to adjust it, and you can modify the trigger time by adding a capacitor, and it gives you the calculations. That's handy. Okay. And a bunch of information that's clearly translated fairly poorly, but I was able to find some other information earlier from some other websites. People that have played with this thing, so we'll follow their footsteps when I get around to playing with this. We have a schematic of the board and physical layout of the board. Oh, would you look at that? Oh, wow. This is almost as good as a data sheet. Gonna have to bookmark this one. That is awesome. Next thing in, it calls itself a radiator. That's a pretty skinny envelope. So what do we have here? We have 5 adhesive back heat sinks. Oh, I remember what I ordered these for. When I was building that lighting rig up above me here, back a bunch of videos ago, back maybe 3-4 months, I was playing with some buck converters to get the voltage down to the 12 volts that it wants, and they all kept getting crazy hot. Buck converters like this one here. Matter of fact, that was the one that I was playing with, I believe. Now then, that the actual chip that does 99% of everything on there says it can handle a lot more amperage than it was letting on with the heat that it had. So I ordered these guys and finally came in off the slow boat from China, so I'll have to give those a try. Looks like I ordered a couple of batches of heat sinks, but the ones that I got is the 5-piece 11 by 11 millimeter ones, which I bought from Easy Shopping 678 for the princely sum of 99 Canadian pennies. I'm going to guess free shipping because it doesn't say anything about shipping. And they are no longer selling it. Lots of other people are selling similar things, and you should have no trouble finding it. It's just aluminum heat sinks. Next thing. Description. Gift. As usual, totally unhelpful. We got in here, looks like chip sockets. Anything else in there? No. Oh, specifically ZIF sockets. Okay. I think I remember what that was for, what I bought that for. Actually, last mailbag, I got a couple of ATmega 328Ps. Not this one, but a couple of new ones. I think I ordered that so that I can create a bit of a programming jig. I think that's what I was planning on doing. Yeah, so I can just drop them in there. And that'll take pretty much any size of dip type chip from something big like that down to something tiny like Mr. 555 or 417. Actually, I could put that into a circuit board, and I could put both of those in at different places just for the hell of it. But that's not really what I wanted it for. This right here is what I wanted it for. The ZIF sockets, 40-pin ZIF sockets. Again, the listing has expired from that seller. I happened to buy them from eCheck 1113 for $1.25 Canadian for the pair of them. All right, item number 4. Oh, this time I can't blame Canada Post for covering up the customs declaration. It's the Chinese Post Office. Electronic components. Nice and generic. What do we got in here? Lee Shop. Well, I know who I bought it from anyway. What module is this? Logic analyzer. It says 24 megahertz, 8 channel. Okay. So we connect to USB on one side, and then we have 8 input channels and a ground and a power by the looks of it. A few weeks ago, well, I ordered this probably over a month or two ago. Oh, there we go. When did I order this? October. But recently, somewhere between when I ordered that and when it actually showed up, Ralph Bacon was playing with a very similar unit on his channel. And he's actually got some great videos. He goes really in depth, explains things nice and patiently, kind of in the way that I don't. I'm more seat of the pants. He's got things well researched. If you want to learn more about how to use one of these things, go and check out his video. I think you'll really enjoy it. New USB logic analyzer device set. USB cable 24 megahertz, 8 channel 24 megahertz for ARM FPGA M100. Whatever all that means. I bought it from GC Supermarket. It says that they've updated the price, but the current price is $7.94 Canadian or $6.22 American. And see what we have to say about it down here. So sampling rate up to 24 megahertz, or down to 25 kilohertz if you want. Sampling rate of 24 M per S. General applications around 10 meg, enough to cope with a variety of off occasions. 8 channels, yes. Input voltage range, just under 1.5 volt, up to 5.25 volts. So I have to be careful with what I hook them up to. Only 3.3 and 5 volt logic. A binary low is counted as anywhere between minus half a volt and 0.8 of a volt. A binary high anywhere between 2 and 5.25 volts. Works with 5 volt, 3.3 volt, 2.5 and 2.0 volt systems. Might work with 1.8, but not recommended. Input impedance 1 mega ohm, 10 picofarads. It's got a crystal in it that's 24 megahertz plus or minus 20 parts per million, and its accuracy is claimed at plus or minus 42 nanoseconds. Interesting. Package included analyzer device, yes, a USB cable, yes, and DuPont lines, yes, 8 of them, just like it shows in the picture. Well, that didn't actually take that much time. So, let's add a fifth thing to Monday mailbag here. Just so you don't feel ripped off, you know? What have I got in here? Ooh, couple more wee tiny little modules. What are you? Oh man, okay, let's zoom in and see if we can figure these guys out. Ah, are you focused? So what do we have here? We have lefty and righty and ground, 5 volts switch and ground, SW, R plus L plus L, or R and R plus R minus, L plus L minus, and another ground. That's suspiciously like a stereo amplifier. Can I read what those chips have to say for themselves? PAM8403. Yes, I think that is an amplifier module. Let's go and see if I can find my listing for this one. And finally, we have two pieces, 2 channels, 3 watt digital power, PAM8403 Class D audio amplifier board, USB 5 volts. I guessed right. It is, in fact, audio amplifier boards. Huh. Had I looked at the back of it, I would have seen even clearer markings. But looking at the front side, that is precisely what I got. Power supply between 2.5 and 5.5 volts. Output power 3 watts for each channel into a 4 ohm load. So with 8 ohm speakers, it's going to be a little bit lower wattage, but with the same voltage, a higher impedance, you're going to get different wattage. Signal to noise ratio 90 dB, efficiency greater than 90%. Because it's a Class D or digital amplifier. And here is this week's Monday mailbag haul. Looks like an interesting assortment, a couple of modules to play with. This thing's going to take some time to figure out the software on. I tried briefly, just while shooting the video, to get the software loaded up on my old laptop here, but unfortunately I haven't been updating my base software for a while, and reasons. I'll spend some time during the week and try and figure that out, and hopefully on Friday I'll have maybe these, or maybe those power supplies that those are with, or something else. I don't know. I feel like a project or tinkering this week. So, well, tune in on Friday. We'll see what I've done with any of this stuff. Other than that, thanks for watching. If you like saying anything, comment down below. Talk to you in a few days.